Florennes is one of Belgium's two fighter bases, home to the F-16s of No. 1 and No. 350 Fighter Squadron of the Belgian Air Force. Since the departure of NATO's tactical leadership program, and with the involvement of Belgian F-16s in foreign operations, flying activity at the base has gone down relatively speaking. But that changed in the days leading up to the weekend of the 23rd and 24th of June, as dozens of aircraft from all over Europe flew in to take part in the Florennes International Airshow 2012. The show officially opened with a flypast by six Belgian Alpha jets. The civilian acts at the show included Formation Team The Victors from Aeroclub Ursel, flying five Piper PA-28s and presenting a brand new routine in 2012.
Mais en freelance, donc en civil, il pilote Embraer 121 Xingo, Cessna et bien sûr cette Piper PA-28. Son allié à gauche, celui qui est le plus bas maintenant dans le virage à gauche, c'est Luc de Smet. C'est un mécanicien électro-hydraulique. Il travaille sur le port de Anvers et bien sûr il est fanat de l'aviation. À droite de la première formation, parce qu'en fait là, les cinq avions se sont séparés. Et bien sûr, je dois me corriger en fait, parce que les deux avions là, regardez le papier de l'année passée. Le numéro 4, donc à votre droite, maintenant le leader c'est Frick Van Hiften. Et son allié, le numéro 2 à droite là, c'est Matthias Schmidt. Et le bac en dessous, là, pour le Typhoon Break. Tout en dessous. En we luisteren naar de bevelen van Manu de Kamer. Réaction où les avions équipés avec des moteurs beaucoup plus puissants, ça a l'air un peu plus impressionnant, mais quand même ici pour effectuer ces manœuvres là à cette vitesse avec des moteurs de 160 chevaux, donc les équipiers doivent travailler pour garder leur position. C'est beaucoup plus difficile avec ce type d'avion à basse vitesse, ils sont beaucoup plus susceptibles aux rafales de vent, il y a beaucoup plus de changements. Et bien sûr, à chaque déplacement de leur position idéale, ils doivent faire des corrections, que ce soit avec les commandes que, ou les moteurs. Donc,
3, 2, 1, 3. No show would be complete without some aerobatics, and these came from Etienne Verhellen with his Yak 52. Jordanian Falcons are officially part of the Royal Jordanian Airlines, and they also fly aerobatics aircraft, four extra 300Ls.
Instructor for jet pilots. He's major, 37 years old,
and still single.
Married and has three children. So the pilots normally stay between 3 and 5 years with the team for the next break.
For the first time in Belgium, and probably Western Europe for that matter, the Baltic Bees. They were founded in 2008 and have their home base at Tukums in Latvia.
Rolling loop. En fait, c'est une feuille de trèfle pour l'oreille. On va voir ce qu'ils vont faire.
Just like the better-known Breitling jet team, they fly the Czech-built L-39 Albatross, though, as will become clear during their display, that's not the only thing they have in common with them.
Formatie te veranderen. Dus ze zijn nu in een zwaanformatie en zouden normaal moeten overgaan op het papiertje toch naar een V-formatie of echelonformatie. les boucles et la descente, normalement, il y aura l'éclatement pour terminer la partie grande formation. Et là, on va avoir une partie beaucoup plus dynamique avec un solo et les quatre avions. Rolling pass.
Here we see the Baltic Bees performing the Apache roll, a maneuver introduced by Jacques Botelin, leader of the Brightning Jet team. Notice the attractive bee-like paint scheme on the aircraft.
Natuurlijk speciaal gemaakt voor de fotografen. Oké, we kijken natuurlijk rechts vooraan voor een volgende manoeuvre, het is house. Ik weet natuurlijk niet wat daarmee de bedoeling is.
There was an extensive reenactment area to help celebrate the 70th anniversary of the airbase. The base was founded by the Germans back in 1942, and the barn in the background is probably the most prominent structure that remains from those days. After the Germans, the Americans took over at Florennes. There were also some historical aircraft in the flying display, like this MS-406. The leading French fighter during the Battle of France in 1940, so before the founding of Florennes Air Base. This B-51 Mustang, piloted by Frederik Formezele, represents the US Army Air Force, which took over from the Germans in 1944, though Florennes was mainly used by P-38 Lightnings and B-26 Marauders. Thank you. After the war, the Belgian Air Force came to Florennes, and these T-6s, flown by Danica Boter and Erik Vormezele, date back to that era. The Hunter was never stationed at Florennes, though with 256 of these jets in Belgian service, it was probably still a familiar sight at the base. This one belongs to the Dutch Hawker Hunter Foundation, based at Leeuwarden. The first fighter of the Belgian Air Force was the Spitfire, and these aircraft were the first Belgian aircraft to be stationed at Florennes from
1947. Je me rappelle plus tout à fait tous les marques, mais je crois qu'on a eu de pousser le sang toujours vers la tête, vers le cerveau.
And here, the first fighter of the Belgian Air Force teams up with the latest one, the F-16 Fighting Falcon, flown by Renault Thys of 350 Squadron, based at Florennes. Commandant Thys is the new Belgian Air Force F-16 solo display pilot and is an excellent ambassador at aviation events all over Europe. During his display, he drops flares several times, which are meant to lure heat-seeking missiles away from the aircraft in combat. Thank you. Here we see senior captain Alain Collard and the other Red Devils taxi him by. With their four Marchetti SF260 trainers, they formed the Belgian national display team. In the Belgian Air Force, the Marchetti is used for elementary pilot training at Beauvechamp. After the first part, with all four aircraft in formation, the team splits up in a formation of three and one solo pilot, Lieutenant Stefan Braam.
Drie vliegtuigen terug aan vliegbaan rechts. Voilà, je zit net voor het publiek. En ze gaan terug het geloverlief, dat is een klaverblad uitvoeren. Dus denk ik, dat is een looping. En tijdens het klimmen wordt er een 9 graden bocht uitgevoerd. Zodat ze 9 graden van richting veranderen. En dit is dit dus 4 maal na elkaar moesten uitvoeren. Wel, dan vliegen ze terug in de originele richting. En line-up rest dus nummer 2 en 3 die dus net opgeleid zijn met de leider. En dus nu terug een looping uit. No Belgian airshow would be complete without the seeking from 40 Squadron at Coxside, performing a winching to demonstrate its main search and rescue role. This is Belgium's main battlefield helicopter, used for reconnaissance, troop transport, armored interdiction and medevac, the A109, based at Beauvechamp. This demonstration is performed by Lieutenants Igor Kraags and Philip Peremans. The paint scheme of this A109 is different on both sides. On the port side, we see the emblem of 18 Squadron, whereas the starboard side is adorned with the griffon of 17 Squadron, the two operational units flying the A109 in Belgian service. Een toestel dat in de jaren 90 werd aangeschaft
And another novelty this year is the inclusion of flares in the A109 display.
Les pilotes à bord de cet A109, ils sont deux, le lieutenant Igor Krax, qui est dans sa troisième année de présentation, et son copilote, le lieutenant Philippe Pierre-Mans, dans sa première année de pilote de présentation du A109.
Pirouetting along the crowd line is a French EC-120, based at Dax. It certainly has its place at the Belgian Air Force's show, as these helicopters are not only used to train French, but also Belgian helicopter pilots. More French training aircraft, three TB-30 Epsilons from Cognac. This is the French Air Force theme Cartouche Dorée, and their aircraft were a new attractive paint scheme for the 2012 season. The French Epsilon fleet is being cut down to 24 aircraft as the Group 120 gradually takes over part of the Epsilon's training role. But with 24 aircraft remaining, Cartouche Dorée can probably continue for a while longer.
À l'info center. Est attendu à l'info center. Merci.
Regarde, on se négocie un peu. Forme. Induction 1965. Séparation. Top. Percussion et top. Pour le leader. Top. Percussion, top et top. Réduction 16,85. Ça tourne encore. Ça tourne toujours. Et cadence. Colonne. Top, top, top. Et vont effectuer en sommet un rétablissement. Écartement. Top. Et exactement. Top. Et top.
Another training aircraft, but this one comes from a lot further. This is a Croatian PC-9, used for pilot training in the Croatian Air Force.
Right in front of you, you can see demo pilot of Croatian Air Force taking off to perform a short but very attractive display as a presentation of skill, discipline, high degree of training quality of Croatian pilots.
This turboprop demonstration is performed by Captain Čovak.
Right in front of you, you can see demo pulling up, performing 90 degrees turn loop. In this moment, pilot endures forces at least 5 times stronger than force of gravity. You can see pilot turning away to prepare for next maneuver. At the top point, demo will enter in a 4-turn spin. We can see the first spin and the second one and the third one and the fourth one. Ladies and gentlemen, 4-turn spin by solo pilot of Croatian Air Force. Right away, pilot goes vertical again, but this time to perform a tail slide. At the top point, the airplane will lose all the speed and will slide down backward. Tail slide by Croatian Air Force demo. Pay attention at the top point of the loop. Pilots will perform a dynamic roll. Excellent dynamic roll by solo pilot of Croatian Air Force. Right away, pilot will perform climbing rolls and a split S at the far left side of the runway. Solo will perform a standard fast roll, but he will stop every 90 degrees for a moment. Just to remind you, 550 kilometers per hour is more than 150 meters per second. Right in front of you can see your health roll and beautiful inverted flyby. After this attractive flyby, Captain Čovak will perform a negative loop with minus 2.5 G. But at the top point of the loop, he will enter in the 2-turn spin right before landing. On the far right side of the runway, solo performing spin right before landing. On your right, PC9 with gear down, lights on, ready to land. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed this short and attractive display performed by solo pilot Captain Josip Čolak. Stay tuned, because at 6 p.m. you'll be able to see Croatian Air Force display team Krila Luje. Thank you for your patience. Best regards from Croatian Air Force display team.
More Pilatus turboprop trainers. This is the Swiss Air Force PC-7 team. And here the takeoff of the Swiss F-18, before joining up for a flyby. The Swiss F-18 solo display easily ranks among the best solo displays in Europe. The pilot is Hauptmann Ralf Knittel, and he is part of 17 Squadron based at Payerne. PC-7 is built by Swiss aircraft manufacturer Pilatus.
Pilatus PC-7 turboprop aircraft is the biggest turbopropeller aircraft team in the world. We will not amaze you.
PC-7 team is the world's largest turboprop team, with 9 aircraft performing an aerial ballet.
wide formations like the ones we show you right now are more difficult to fly, the farther away the pilot has to hold its position in the reference to the lead element. With only little power left to play with, the outer wings are constantly facing a situation and not being able to hold the position as the formation turns in front of us. Depending whether the most outer pilot is located on the inside or outside position of a turret.
The team's PC-7s are actually upgraded aircraft, the NPC-7.
Follow our presentation and closely for the entire duration, the quickest 20 minutes in your life, or maybe at least today.
Remarkably, the team does not have a home base, and the pilots are F-18 pilots for their day jobs.
This aircraft is a lookout mode. That's where we usually start our yearly training. The team has now changed in the Vulcan formation. So we started with Pell, now you see the Vulcan, and within 1/360, they're gonna do one more formation change into the Super Losange. Aerobatic maneuvers to be propeller aircraft. Flying and maneuvers are close together and completed very quickly. The F-18 Hornets and gets called Dido. Wonderful. Those red and white aircraft here over Florennes. Wonderful, well done, Basel. That was a really impressive crossing. Thanks. Have a nice day. Enjoy the great air show. Goodbye. See you maybe tomorrow or another day.
Another PC-7. This one comes from Zeltweg in Austria.
Ik heb die allemaal van Griekenland. Ik heb die allemaal van Griekenland.
La musique royale de la force aérienne belge prend 15 minutes de pause. Ça me permet de vous rejoindre un peu avec les commentaires de tout ce qui s'est déjà passé entre temps et ce qui va se passer d'ici une heure ou deux heures.
The PC-7 is also in use with the Royal Netherlands Air Force to train pilots who may later progress to this plane, the F-16. The Dutch F-16 display pilot for 2012 is Stefan Hutten, or Stitch, and he is part of 312 Squadron based at Volkel. In the days of the Cold War, these would have been targets for the F-16. These are two Polish Su-22 fighter strike aircraft, and as you can clearly see, they have swing wings. Both planes are based at Świdnin in the northwest of Poland. This is a more modern strike aircraft from Central Europe, an L-159 Advanced Light Combat Aircraft, a further development of the L-39 Albatross trainer, like we saw flying with the Baltic Bees.
dezelfde familie hebben dan hier een voorstelling van de helft.
This aircraft is operated by the Czech Air Force. And another former target, the MiG-29. This one belongs to the Slovak Air Force and is based at Sliač. Following the withdrawal of the Spanish Patrulla Aguila from the show, due to Spanish budget cuts, Patrulla de France stepped in to fill the gap on quite short notice and once again provided a remarkable spectacle in the skies over Florennes.
L'enchaînement d'une boucle, du tourne et du renverse,
vous disais donc, par l'enchaînement d'une boucle, d'une tournée, du renverse, les fumées vont décrire, et vous le voyez maintenant, une sphère comme si ils enroulaient une planète. Et pour les fans, comme dirait Johnny, parce que ça tourne. Et le passage en formation Concorde de la patrouille de France 2012. Observez bien le charnier à l'arrière du losange, c'est le commandant Raphaël Nall, 34 ans, pilote de Mirage F1 qui a participé lui aussi à de nombreuses opérations en Afghanistan et en Libye. Après ce trèfle à gauche dans la remontée, il va se faufiler entre les solos pour reformer le diamant. Et ça y est, il est en place!
Now in its second display season is Solo Turk, the Turkish Air Force F-16 solo display. Pilot in 2012 is Fatih Batmaz.
Eksi 3 çeyrek insan limitlerini zorlayan hareket izledik. Dikkat by side with clear.
After descent, we will show you the sound of aircraft. Sizler için ay yıldızımızı tüm gürültüsüyle, heybetiyle önünüze geçiriyoruz.
Saw the Croatian PC9 solo display earlier. Here is their national display team, Krila Oluje, flying six of these aircraft.
During their show, Krila Oluje pilots fly at just 0.5 feet one from each other at speed of around 500 kilobits per hour. They endure forces up to 6 times greater than force of gravity. After loop that you just saw, Krila Oluje changing formation one more time to rocket 6. They proceeded to right turn. Pay attention on your right hand side. You can see Krila Oluje in preparation for left barrel roll. Barrel roll, Krila Oluje proceeding to right 45 degrees bank loop. This is also a very demanding maneuver because pilot needs to change from positive to negative flight and still maintain tight formation. Ladies and gentlemen, prepare your camera. Invert the Delta 6 formation by Krila Oluje. Mm-hmm. also pay attention on our very attractive exit from the maneuver. On position number 4, flying as slot pilot and synchro pair leader, is Major Matija Varžuka, team Baron since 2005, total amount 1,400 flying hours. During this crossover, formations approach each other with speed difference of around 1,000 km per hour. Feral Row crossover by Krila Lue. From your left hand side, three ship formation performing Blanca or tail slide. Formation tail slide by Krila Oluye. Distance between airplanes in this moment is less than 3 meters. Captain Cristo performing standard roll, but he will stop every 90 degrees for a moment. First to the left, then to the right. Major Varžuka and Major Hastin flying face to face at about 450 kilometers per hour, just few feet away from each other. They will change formation to Tango 4 to Diamond 4 at the top of the loop. Right away they are proceeding to fast barrel roll in front of you. Synchro pair. On position number 3, flying as right wing, is Captain Sinisha Hutsika, team member since 2009, with total amount of 1,350 flying hours. Pilot will separate from the diamond formation to perform his solo act. Pay attention about you. Solo will enter in 4 turn spin. And we see first one. And the second one. And the third. And the fourth. And even the fifth. 5 turn spin by a solo pilot of Krila Lue. After recovery from the frontal spin, solo is turning left. From your right to perform formation synchro roll. Number 2 and number 3 performing wide roll. But the rest of the formation is performing fast synchro roll. Then numbers 4 and 5 will do the same thing.
Prepare me for first.
Speed at the top point of the second loop is less than 100 kilometers per hour. This is very demanding maneuver because first loop is performed with maximum speed and maximum G load, while the other one is performed with stalling speed and with almost no G load at the top of the loop. Right away they are changing from line abreast to Delta 5. Just to remind you, gap between formations in this moment is around 3 meters. Ladies and gentlemen, Dia. Pay attention on a quick and very attractive exit from the maneuver and formation change into Yankee 6. After flyby, team is proceeding to the left to prepare for last maneuver today.
And we end this look at the Florennes International Airshow with a fourth F-16 display. For the first time in Belgium, this is the Hellenic solo display, nicknamed Zeus. This is a two-seat F-16D, flown by Captain Andrelakis from 343 Squadron, based at Chania.
Thank you. prepare for a slow speed high alpha path.
This final pass, we conclude our look at the 2012 Florennes Airshow. All that is left to show is the departure of all these wonderful participants the public could admire in Belgium over the weekend.